issues, right? So absolutely. So that's really what's going to be needed in the future. Now, if you look at what Forbes did, they every year they put out what the skills are needed. Now, they're not admin specific, but if you look at the skills that we need to have for 2020, we need to have analytical thinking skills. We have them. So what we also need to do is have the confidence to say them. It's one thing to say, I can't believe we're doing this again. It's another thing to do, to say, let me give you another perspective to think about and to get that confidence behind us, right? We need to actively learn. We need to know technology. We need to have our computer skills. We need to have our personal skills. We need to have good judgment. We need to have emotional intelligence and creativity, and we need to embrace change and leadership and all the things that, you know, we're always learning about. Those are the skills that Forbes says we need to have. So if the skills of what we keep needing keep growing, then what about the skills we don't need? So as I said, the half-life of colleges dropped from three to six years. And so the expression, I learned that in school, or I'll learn that in school, is dead. And so it's really not going to be about degrees. Jobs will not be redundant. People will be redundant because what they didn't do is upskill. So we can get rid of all that scheduling Tetris. We can get rid of taking minutes, although I love to teach you to take minutes. We can get rid of filing. I know that I sent everybody a handout, but I'm willing to bet most of you did not print it. Why? You don't have a printer. And you know what? You don't need it either, right? So we get rid of all of that stuff. We're not going to be organizing things. We're not going to be booking travel. You know, in my book, Alexa Stealing Your Job, which you can get on Amazon, I use a story in there where you've got your executive who's on the phone. So let's assume your executive is Joan. You work for Joan, and Joan's on the phone with Lucy. And Lucy says, I think that you should come over to Spain and we should have a meeting in person. And Joan says, I agree, Lucy. I'm going to arrange a flight over to Spain and we'll have this one-on-one meeting. Of course, I'm pretending there's no pandemic and we can do all this sort of stuff. And Lucy and Joan talk about what they're going to do, when it's going to be, what date works for you. Let's do the 15th of November. That's great. Joan hangs up the phone and Alexa, or whoever sitting on her desk, says, Joan, just so you know, I booked you a first class ticket on United leaving November 15th. You'll arrive on the 16th at 8 a.m. Your car will be arranged. I've got you at the Marriott Residence Inn. And Alexa listening is going to have that done. Joan's not even going to need to worry about it. And Alexa knows that Joan wants to sit in first class, that she wants an aisle seat. She doesn't want to be in the front row. She knows that what her Marriott number is, you know, that sort of stuff is just going to be done. So those are the things that we don't need to do. Now, what we're going to do is maybe, okay, now that Joan, we've got your trip all planned, I just opened up 45 minutes of my day. Let's sit down and bring up some talking notes that we can talk to Lucy about, right? So that's what our day is going to be. So in order to be relevant, in order to make sure that Alexa does not steal your job, we need to upskill and stay relevant. We need to be competitive. We need to embrace bot-based empowerment. We need to use that as our admins. So we need to create those fusion skills. One of the skills that you really need to get good at is the ability to ask questions. And I heard Melba talking about that as well. You need to be the most inquisitive person on the planet. Ask the question, even if you think you know the answer, just to be sure. And then ask the next great question. Anticipate when a machine can't make the next great question. Anticipate when it doesn't know the answer. And so AI is going to take over predictable and well understood tasks. We're then going to take those up to the next level. We need to create what's new, right? So upskill is one of the three tips that we need to remain relevant. If you stay right where you are right now, you will be out of a job. Now, if you stayed right where you were in February before the pandemic, you'd be out of a job, right? Because we didn't learn how to do all this virtual stuff. We didn't learn how to do a lot of the skills that we've picked up. So continually upskill. I have a Google alert set on Alexa for Business. I'm an Alexa fan. I'm an iPhone girl, but I know that Apple is coming out with their own one. So then I'll be in trouble. But Alexa and I are buddies. I'm not going to fall in love with her or anything like that. But she learns my habits. She learns my accent. She learns what I do. So I have a Google alert on Alexa for Business, and you'd be amazed at how many business processes are already integrated into artificial intelligence. So we need to upskill. So keep your eyes on that. Get get comfortable at home with your AI. Start using Siri on your phone. Start thinking about maybe getting some type of device in your life that I'm going to give you a couple of examples in a minute as well that you can use. You also, the second tip to remain relevant is intelligent interrogation. Learn to ask questions. Silence. And I know some people say better to be silent and be thought a fool than to open your mouth and remove all doubt. Totally disagree. If you're invisible, you get forgotten. Start asking questions. Start asking the tough questions. Nobody